We took a lot of pride in trailblazing and how the game was played. I knew at that time when I was 8, I wanted to be an entertainer, and I love the idea of that.
It wasn't me, personally, that they didn't like. It was that I wasn't being me.
Life brings like drama, and you gotta deal with this person and a funky relationship.
Yes, I get up at crazy hours, whether it's 3 o'clock in the morning, by the way, when we were talking in London, mm-hmm. I was getting up at 3 because I had to be on set by 4.
It is the worst mistake you will ever make. He said, you're ruining your career.
Love action, and I love kicking ass. But the goal was to become a better actor. Get your ass kicked, get back up, and you put the gloves back on and you swing away.
When I was 16 years old, that was the last time that I was arrested. I don't know how it happened, but my cousin, who was on tour with us, I said, just got busted with prostitutes, and my name is attached to it now.
We were bad. We intimidated, we dominated, but we took a lot of pride in that. We took a lot of pride in trailblazing and how the game was played back at that time. Through, we would intimidate teams and we would want to dominate teams. But also, too, we also had the thought process that a team was never going to outwork us. We were going to be the hardest working team in the country. And check this out. What we would do, for example, we would go into, so we had a big game against Florida State. So we would go into their Doak Campbell Stadium. And instead of going through your general practice, what you do, what we would do is we would do things a little bit different just to intimidate them. So as a team, we would kind of all line up. We're in their stadium. You got their staff. You got some players watching us. Instead of going through our plays, we would just start to give cadence calls. I wanted to entertain. When I was 8 years old, I thought I was a combination of these guys. I thought I was a combination of Chuck Norris, Richard Pryor, Harrison Ford, and Rocky Balboa, and Harrison Ford from Indiana Jones. So I was like all these guys and Elvis Presley too, at 8, right?
Pretty lofty ambition.
Yes, exactly.
I remember I had great angst every night before I went out because I was not able to be myself.
Sensation of the year. Rocky Balboa, Intercontinental Champion, and yes, I
am. My very first WrestleMania, the biggest show of the year, the Super Bowl, of wrestling.
It's not just all luck, is it? Well, this is Rocky.
That night, 20,000 fans started chanting Rocky sucks. It was a sobering moment, and that was the beginning of the end of my initial run in the WWE. A few weeks later, I tore a tendon in my knee, and I was out for the rest of the summer. And I came to the realization before I went back that it wasn't me, personally, that they didn't like. It was that I wasn't being me.